Hey everyone, in today's video, I wanted to talk about Wunderlist, which is one of my favorite apps that I use every single day. And it's a checklist to-do app. So if you're trying to keep track of things to do, both personally and professionally, Wunderlist is the one app that I recommend more than any other. And I've been using it for maybe 2 years now, and I use it every single day. I have tasks for daily, I have tasks for monthly, and I have an overall year plan, like almost like a roadmap that I have in a different folder. So I wanna show you how to get Wunderlist, how to set it up, and how to organize it to get the best performance out of the app every single day. And you could sync it between your devices, so you could be on the go on your phone and then jump into the computer and vice versa, and have it all synced up across all the platforms that you use, all the different devices that you use. So let's jump into the computer. I'll show you the download process and the setup process right now. Now, if it's your first time here, I make tech tutorials and app tutorials just like this one 5 times a week. So please consider subscribing. So to get Wunderlist, go ahead and check out wunderlist.com. I'll have a link in the description to the website, and it's available for all these platforms. So if you're on a Mac, in this case, I'm on a Mac, it will work on a Mac, iPhone. It actually is automatically linked between my Mac and my iPhone, between the devices once I log in. So everything I do on the Mac happens on the iPhone, happens on the iPad. But if you're on the Android or Windows phones, same scenario. So go ahead and download it. So when I press download here, it'll take me to view it in the App Store. And since I've already been using this app, I already have it downloaded. So let me go ahead and press open. But if you don't have it yet, just go ahead and go through the usual download process. Let me go ahead and minimize these. So once you download Wunderlist and open it up, the app on a desktop looks like this. So you'll have to go ahead and either create a free account or sign in. Since I've already been using this for a long time, I'm gonna go ahead and sign into my account. And once you're signed into the app, it will look something like this. Obviously, this part of the app will be blank for you, but I've been using it for the last couple of years, so I have a lot built up here on the side. But I'm gonna show you how to create tasks, how to organize them, how to create folders. And basically the way I've been using it, I just wanna show you how I get the most out of this app. So once you're on this app, over here is where your login information is. And you could just go ahead and press sync. And if you have this downloaded in other devices, it will sync. Now you won't have to do this all the time. It actually does it in the background. And it works really fast. So when I add a new task here, I usually see it a second later on my other devices. So I really haven't had to do a sync now on this app because it does it automatically. And you could sign up to become a pro member, which just gives you some other options, some unlimited file storage, some unlimited subtasks and things like that that you don't have in the free version. Is about $5 a month. I'm not gonna do that right now. You could change your background here. So if you wanted a different background, you could easily change that here. But let's say we'll just go with this background. I'll show you the most important part, which is creating a task. So right here, add a to-do list. So your to-do list could be go to gym. That could be a to-do list. And you could just press enter. And once you press enter, that task has been added to whatever box you had checked on here. So this is my inbox. This is where I created that. And I'll show you a couple of other settings with that. If I click it, it'll give me all the options on the side. So I could set a due date. So let's say this is due today. And I could repeat it every single day. So if I wanted to go to the gym every single day, I could give myself a daily reminder. Press done. And you could set that reminder to be at a specific time, 6 p.m. You could create a subtask under that task. So for the gym, you could have subtasks like do cardio. That could be a subtask under this big task. So now if I click this, I could see those under that main to-do. So this is a great way to organize it, more like a roadmap. So let's say you didn't want a task that you created. Go ahead and select it, and you could easily delete this by just pressing the garbage can down here. So if I press the garbage can, it will go away. Delete to do, that's fine. I'll click this one more time. You could also add notes to the task. You could add comments to the task, and you could add it to your favorite. So if you click the star, it makes it a priority. It'll be right up on top of the to-do list. And if you click it here, it'll make it go away. So I'm just gonna go ahead and remove this daily reminder here. And once you're done with a task, all you gotta do is press check mark and it'll show up under the complete to-do and it'll look like this. At any time, if you accidentally press that, you could go ahead and press it again and it'll skip it. Now let me go to a different folder here. So this was in my inbox here. I'll go to daily tasks. And if I click on any of these tasks here, for example, this one creates a tech video 5 times a week, I could go ahead and share that with someone else. So I could add other people as my members to my task list. This is my personal account, so I don't do this, but this is a great way to collaborate with people on tasks that you have due. So you could create this for work and create folders. Now, that's how you create a task and share it and create to-dos for yourself. Now, let me show you how to organize this by folder. So on the side here, all these are basically ways I organize my tasks. So I could have daily tasks. These I have set to be due every single day of the week. I could have tasks for a quarter. So these for Q1 2018, I had a lot of tasks. And you could do monthly tasks, weekly tasks, however you want to organize it. This is a great way to organize it. And for 2017, for example, I used to do a lot of daily tasks. So I used to put the dates, wake up, put the things I had to get done that day and organize it this way. And for example, on this day, it looks like I did 30 things that I completed that day. And I organized them once 2017 was done into that folder. For this channel, for the YouTube channel, I have a lot of videos that I'm gonna record, so I made a to-do list. So let me show you how to make this folder. Down here, press the plus sign and go ahead and list a name. So you want a new list. Let's call this videos to make. I'm gonna go ahead and press okay. I don't need to list any members, but you could do that right up front, create the list. And once that list is created, you could go ahead and right click or command click on here and create a folder. So I'm gonna go ahead and create a folder and I'll name that folder. So now that to do is within that folder. So I could go ahead and extend it out. So now for Howfinity, if I had all my tasks, which I do here, I could go ahead and see all the different things. So all the different YouTube channels I have here are their own list, all within that main primary folder. And you could always grab things and put it into different folders just like that and bring them out to really get this organized. And at any time, you could go ahead and right click and rename it and ungroup a folder. So that way it just came out of the folder. And if I want to delete this task, I could again right click or command click and just delete it and it'll just go away. So that's the way I organize my tasks into folders. And sometimes I'll put them in the inbox where I need to get them done right away. I'll put them on my to-do for today's list. I'll put them the daily task list that I built. So there's a lot of different way to organize this and get the most out of it. Let me just show you one last thing. If you come up to Wunderlist preferences or on a PC, I believe it's under file preferences, go ahead and look under notification and you could set it up to get a desktop notification. So on a Mac, those are the ones that pop up on my desktop, or you could get an email notification. That's the email you use to sign up for this account. So if you use Gmail or Facebook, that's the email attached to that. That'll be the email it will send the notifications to. So since I'm on my desktop a good amount of time, I actually have email turned off, so I don't need to get an email from Wunderlist, but this is a great option to keep track of what you need to get done and when you need to get it done. Anyway, I hope this was helpful for you. Using checklists just like this have been one of the most productive things I've done in the last couple of years that really have excelled my YouTube growth and things in my business and personal life. So I hope you could really utilize this app. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to this channel. I post tutorials just like this one 5 times a week on this channel. So I hope to see you on the next video. Thank you so much for watching this one.